It's the sad case of those students at the Nasarawa State University. And we still don't know what's going on there. The army says that they were not involved. And those who were there said that those who came and shot at the students were wearing army uniform. So what would we make of that?
I don't know. I saw that on Channel's television news some days ago with the chief of army staff and the commandant for that area. Saying and reading out a statement that the army was not there, but the people who saw it, who witnessed it, said that definitely the army was there, and it was the army, the soldiers that were said to have shot those young people dead and injured several of them.
Why should in 2013 students are innocently protesting and police, army, whatever, sends out their people with live ammunition.
Live ammunition, I cannot understand. Go out, that's like go out and kill them.
Yes.
And the day it happened, I put out a tweet and said, the federal government has got to investigate this. And I am terribly disgusted at the federal government of Nigeria that the president has not deemed it fit
to make any kind
to say
of
that this is completely unacceptable.
Completely out of order.
Chief of army staff, the chief of defense staff, and the whole lot of them, they're carrying on as if our children have not been killed. This is completely unacceptable. The president of Nigeria should be held accountable for this. If the people who report to the president...
Has he said anything about the Alu form?
I have not even heard anything. It is extremely disturbing that this is a trend that is taking place right under our noses in this country. That young people who are said to be the future of this nation, they're being destroyed and wasted in this way.
And
nothing has happened.
The authorities are not saying anything.
They're not saying anything. We're not even hearing of the president saying this is something that is condemned by the presidency, this is something that is condemned by the head of this country, and we will carry out an investigation, we'll find out why people with live bullets will go and kill people because they're
Protesting. They're carrying placards.
They're protesting because of scarcity of water. Should they even be protesting about scarcity of water in the first place? Should that be an issue in a university? I don't know of anywhere in the world where there is scarcity of water in a university environment.
Except
in Nigeria.
Yeah.
It shouldn't be happening in the first instance. And yet, because of that, they're now deemed as criminal that should be wasted in this way.
Wasted like common criminals.
And the federal government has said nothing. And they then put on television some...
When we were in university, we never had water issues. We never had power issues. There was always power on campus.
There's
always water on campus.
Even when there wasn't, it wasn't such a big
issue. Is to go and study.
Yes.
So how can you study when you're carrying buckets around looking for water? You're putting a better pass my neighbor in front of your room and stuff like that. It's just not going to work. You will
not
be able to concentrate on the job you have to do.
And obviously that explains why there is not a single Nigerian university in the top, is it top 60, top 100
top
of universities, top 200 in
top
the...
1,000?
Yeah, we're not there. We're not in any top anything.
Well, kudos to Babatunde Rajaifashola, who is determined to make sure that LASU is among the top 100 universities.
Yes.
In the near future.
Yes. And we're hoping that that will happen in this generation. Maybe not before he leaves office, but we hope that he will lay the foundation for that, so that that university will be one of those that
Nigeria
will be respected.
Nigeria will be in the calendar somewhere.
Yes.
Or in the list somewhere.